Some breaking news coming in now here on ANN7. WITS students have lost an urgent interdict to stop the university from holding that referendum on the resumption of its academic program. Now, some protesting students, represented by advocate Dali Mpofu, tried to interdict the WITS poll in the South Gauteng High Court last night, but lost that case. Now, the WITS poll will thus go ahead from now. It starts now at 7 o'clock, and results will be announced tomorrow. That's Friday the 30th of September. So the students having lost that urgent interdict, the court ruling in favour of the university, and that referendum will now go ahead as it has begun. Now that students can vote via SMS, with the staff members allowed to vote online to try and get an indication whether the majority of students and staff would like to see the academic program continue this coming Monday. And that is the breaking news, that urgent interdict, the court ruling in favor of the university. So we'll keep you up to date. No doubt plenty of reaction going to come in from the students throughout the day. Our reporter is on the ground there to try and get a sense of the reaction coming in. The students were represented by advocate Dali Mpofu, but they've lost that battle to try and stop the referendum taking place. So that will go ahead today, and that is on the back of that court ruling. Well, that referendum is set to start as of now to gauge whether the majority of the university want to reopen this coming Monday. The online poll among students and staff is to weigh the majority mood to determine whether academic activity should resume on Monday. The polling will be via anonymous text message for students and via a website link for staff members. It's expected to last for 12 hours. The voting will be overseen by the IEC for confirmation of free and fair elections. However, students are up in arms against that referendum. They claim that the online voting process can be manipulated, and they've sought that urgent interdict, but it have since lost that interdict. Joining us now on the phone line, WITS spokesperson Sharona Patel. Sharona, good morning to you. You must be relieved at this decision, but yet at the same time a little bit concerned as to how the students are going to react.
Yes, so thank you for having me this morning. So WITS University was set to go ahead with the poll this morning. It's opened already. It opened at 7 this morning. It will run until 4 o'clock. It's an electronic poll, and students will be responding to the poll via SMS and staff via a website link through email. Now, last night, I think it's around 11 o'clock or so, in the South Gauteng High Court, heard the case where a group of protesting students, represented by advocate Dali Mpofu, took the university to court in an attempt to block the poll. They did not want the poll to go ahead today. And the judge, after much deliberation, ruled in favor of the university. That means that the poll can go ahead today from 7 to 4.
Mm. Sharona, are you concerned that there may be students out there who may feel a little bit threatened in terms of voting? It's going to be anonymous, I understand that. But there may be students out there who feel a little bit threatened if they do vote, either way.
Well, that's why we went and opted for the electronic voting. This is so students can respond via an SMS to their phone directly. If we had to go with any other form of voting, I think we would have more trouble in terms of people being intimidated, etc. In this way, people need not come to campus to vote. They can vote via their cell phones. Staff can vote via an email link. And it's just safer for everybody at this stage. Remember that university activities still remain suspended until further notice. We are hopeful that through asking the question via the poll today, whether students and staff want to return to class on Monday, if there's a sufficient security presence, that more people will respond. We are hearing through the protesters the voices of at maximum 1,000 people who are protesting currently. There are 37,000 students at WITS. We aren't hearing those voices. That's the reason for the poll. Mm.
Obviously, the concerns, though, that those 1,000 protesters could cause a lot of damage to the university. You must be concerned about that. And should the vote, the referendum vote, that the majority of the students do want to go back on Monday, you've still got to take cognizance of the fact that the 1,000 could cause a lot of disruptions.
Absolutely. And we've done two things in the meantime to try to mitigate that. So firstly, the Vice Chancellor has called for an urgent meeting with the Minister of Police, the Minister of Justice, and the Minister of Higher Education and Training. Yesterday, he met with the MEC for Safety and Security and other key figures. We are also working on a security plan for Monday. But what we'd like to say is that that's not the ideal way to go. We saw what happened at Rhodes yesterday. We saw what happened at WITS last week. We don't want campuses full of security and police people. What we'd like is we are saying to the students, come back to class, don't disrupt classes or university activities, don't intimidate others, and don't hold the academic program to ransom. Do those things, and the security and police are gone. We're also saying, though, that people who then disrupt or infringe on the rights of others must be held accountable immediately through suspensions, expulsion. So those are the things we put forward to them. We've tried to engage with the students many times in the last 2 weeks, but they haven't come to any meeting. We've sent formal letters to them. We've reached out by the Dean of Students, but nothing. They're saying that their fight is for free education now. WITS's stance is that we believe that there should be access to quality higher education for those who can't afford it, and we are happy to work with the students to take it forward at the national level, to the state, to the private sector, to other stakeholders in society. But we can't condone the violence that's happening on our campuses. We can't threaten people's lives, etc. So we're hoping that we can still get the right people around the table. The students fight right now is not with the universities, although they're using universities to make a point to national government. And I think we have to be cognizant of that. What we're trying to do now is facilitate a national conversation so that we can actually move forward. The one thing that we can't lose is this academic year, because the people who will suffer the most are people who really need to graduate. There are people who need to go into the workplace, the labor force. We've got accountants who need to write psych exams. We need doctors to graduate because we need more in the system. We need teachers for next year. We also have 22,000 students out of 36,000 on financial aid, scholarships, and bursaries. We can't throw that money away. We can't waste a whole year and let people lose that funding just because 1,000 students are holding 37,000 others to ransom. Mm. So I think from our side, while we try to engage with the students, we're saying the priority now is for the academic program to continue. Mm.
Sharona, just in terms of this referendum that's going to be held, a concern for the protesting students is obviously the university wants the academic program to continue. You've got some independent auditors there for the protesting students who may be watching. Just explain to them how independent this referendum is going to be.
Okay, so we brought in an external auditing company as the IT couldn't come on board this week. But the auditing company has basically looked at the databases. They will then look at they've looked at the SMS system. They've looked at the email system. They will receive a copy of the report as soon as the results come in. So as the registrar of the university obtains the report later today, the auditors will receive the same. They've already tested the report, and the reports show that staff and students will remain anonymous. That means that no one in the university can actually see who's voted and how they voted at least. We will only receive the data and the numbers, that is how many people have voted, how many will say yes, how many will say no, and if there's a percentage of people who've replied in any other way, we'll get that report as well. But the auditors will get it at the same time as WITS, and they will then audit it this evening, and hopefully, we are hoping to release the results by tomorrow at the latest.
Sharona, always good chatting to you. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. WITS spokesperson Sharona Patel on the line.